Welcome to Alphabet City. I'm your guide, Ayaz Akhtar, and you are the most amazing audience in the world. It looks like Stadia is coming to Android TV with Android R in 2020. This is according to a new report by XDA developers. The site received a roadmap for Android TV from a person wishing to remain anonymous. That source says they got the information at the International Broadcasting Convention. The pay version of Stadia is launching in November. You'll be able to play games through the cloud on your TV if you've got a Chromecast Ultra and the Stadia controller. At launch, you'll also be able to use the Pixel 3, the 3A, and XL versions, tablets running Chrome OS, or a computer running a recent version of the Chrome browser. The Pixel 4 should join this list when it gets official on October 15th. The most important part of Stadia is your broadband connection. You need at least 10 megabits per second to get 720p gameplay at 60 FPS with stereo sound. If you're pulling 35 megabits per second, you can get 4K HDR video at 60 FPS with 5.1 surround sound. The roadmap also talks of a hero device advancing next-gen smart home UX, e.g. lens and camera. An Android TV hero device is very interesting. There is a question as to which company will be building it. Here's a list of the top Android TV boxes right now. The Shield TV. Rumors swirl that Nvidia is working on new versions of the Shield TV, which could come out soon. Name another high-profile Android TV box. It's okay, I'll wait. Did I hear someone say the Google Nexus player? Well, that's discontinued. Google does not even make an Android TV device right now. Now, at Google I.O. this year, there was a very sad little Android TV section. They had some televisions with Android TV built in. The sole box was the Nvidia Shield. I pressed Google a bit to find out if there was any new Android TV hardware coming. The rep could not confirm or deny any new hardware. A different rep could not confirm or deny if Stadia was coming to Android TV. Now let's talk a little bit about the Chromecast Ultra. This is the hardware you need to play Stadia on TV at launch. This thing is insane. It costs $70. What does it do on its own? Not a heck of a lot. You always need another device to feed it content. Let's look at Roku. If you spend $40, you get the Roku Premiere. It can output 4K video like the Ultra. Unlike the Ultra, the Roku Premiere comes with a remote and its own OS with tons of TV apps. The Chromecast Ultra seems like a great candidate to be either radically redesigned with Android TV on board or discontinued entirely in favor of an Android TV box. Android TV works really well in my experience, although it does lag behind in getting some of the latest versions of some apps. In the roadmap, Google has a target of 8 to 10,000 apps in 2021 and beyond. I did some digging. Roku had more than 4,500 apps as of January 2017. On the Roku site, the company says its streamers have access to over 500,000 movies and TV episodes. So as I mentioned, Google is holding its Pixel 4 event on October 15th. We're going to try our hardest to be there on the scene, testing out all the things. On to your comments. Manav asks, why is Google even bothering with a launch event? Hey there, I think the event will show off the uses for motion sense and maybe assistant improvements. There's also a rumor that we may see a Pixel Book 2. The original Pixel Book was introduced in October of 2017. Manuel has an idea. I think the big reveal will be pricing. Now that could definitely be interesting. If the Pixel becomes more affordable, I think it would help out with sales. Now Control Freak helping me out, they checked on my Google Lens translation from the last app. As a Chinese speaker, yes, it does say anyone with similar facial features could unlock your phone. Also, what up, Tarek? Thanks to everyone for writing in. If you've enjoyed your stay in Alphabet City, please like and subscribe. I'm Ayaz Akhtar, and I'll see you online.